Now the netting is dry, I'm just going to take the peel the netting off just to get the texture to show up. It's completely dry now, so that should be okay. And I'm also going to take off my masking fluid. I might just leave the masking fluid on beach for the moment until I get a bit more colour on there. And to darken up the browns in the eroded sands, in order to make this a bit stronger, so I'm going to use the burnt sienna and pull this shape out a little bit further. It's not quite far enough out around the shadow, make it darker there, back up into the under part of the eroded bank. As it comes down towards the beach, give a feeling of the different bands of soil trying to keep an angle to the mark making. Also have some of that oranginess up here. I'll put some more of the transparent yellow in that. Colours out into this beachy area. Slightly more red in that. Maybe a little more purple. A bit too strong. Just get this bank beach to kind of come across and then up into this area up here. Bit of shadow underneath those roots. More yellow. So I'm going to get a few more darks in this central section using the purple and the brown, burnt sienna I should say. and some of the blue all together, dark blue, which will give me a nice strong dark. So then I'm going to come in under this log. Start to get these darker shapes in. So it's really quite nice and dark there. Here's my rigger. Darken all this up. Leave a few little gaps in there to suggest some slightly lighter roots. Comes down the side there. Underneath that. And then I'm going to give the suggestion that there's a root coming through here and around, and that's being overlapped by another root coming through there. And these are all coming back into this darker area. Just picking out some of those shapes that the netting has made. Another root here, coming down, and come into a darker area here, which I'm just going to spray. That a light spray, not too strong, just want it to split a bit. Again, we've got another root there coming through, and then we're coming up to the area where they turn. So, got some nice darks in here where the various different bundles meet. Let's bring this down a little bit lower, down into these roots. About to put some darker tones now into the foliage, and then I'm going to drop some salt into it in order to get some of these greens to show back through. So I'm just going to flatten the board a bit, put some water on. Just getting the water back on to the foliage area before I drop on my darks and then the salt. So I'll just get all of that back on there. Okay, we have a nice dark colour, so I'm going to use a dark blue, pretty dark blue, some of the transparent yellow in it. So it's going to be quite a vivid green, quite a strong green. Teeny bit of red. Okay, and then we'll drop this in. Bring this back into the foliage. Get out a light effect to go nice and strong. And then I'm going to drop the salt on top of this. And hopefully we should get a nice combination of the effect. So we'll just quickly get that on there. Coming down a little bit lower. Bring some of that down into some of those little air holes. Link it into the trees. Just mop that up. And then I'm going to get my salt. Put the salt on. Particularly the edges. Want plenty of salt so that the light is lighter at the edges than at the at the lower shadowy part. A bit more up there. Okay, and that will probably do that. I'm going to mop up some of those big areas of colour. Just soak up that a bit. And then while that's still fairly wet, I'll just take a cocktail stick and then through here I'm just going to pull out some little twigs, branches, just to get those sort of feeling a bit more wiry. Let's pull that out. Almost like there's things hanging off the tree. And then let that dry, so let that bleed up a bit. I'm going to re-darken my trunks a bit more. That I'm going to go into my Payne's grey, into those same greeny colours. A bit of brown as well in it. It's pretty dark. Okay, almost black, but not quite. A bit of transparent yellow in there. Tiny touch of red. And then I'm just going to use that to just mop some of those bigger pieces up. So just to get some shadow into my trunk area. A bit of dappled light in the actual trunks while it's still a little bit wet. I'm not filling in the whole shape, I'm just bringing some shadow into these areas, leaving some of the grey showing. There's a bit of dappled light there. Just getting these nice dark shadows to come across the trunk. Which will allow some of these areas to be a bit darker. A bit darker in there. A few darks down here. Coming up this side. Darken up some of those. Perhaps a little bit dark over that. This bit of wood. Lose that up into those greens. Some of these a bit darker. Coming around. Just trying to make it dappled and not be too logical with it. Just a bit of dark here and there. Coming up and over to show that this is a fallen bit of log. I want this to have some roundness to it, to give the sense that it's coming towards us a bit more. A bit more tone underneath it. Down here, as we come into the root bundle, coming under the log here, coming up and over, and then it gets lost into our trees there, perhaps a bit darker here. And then pick out a few more darker bits in here. Start to get some stronger tone on these bits of roots. So it's a case of painting a few, missing a few. A bit more brown in that. Nice and dark in there, coming down to where our nice oranges are. So I now need to put some greens on this tree. So for that, I'm going to take my same grey-green colours with my rigger and pick out some of this trunk here, as it kind of makes its wiry way up, keeping it very, not too strong. Maybe block that off, it might be a bit too strong, that, too dark. And then I'm going to put some greeny colours over the top. We'll just drop some greens in there, using some of our olivey green colours. So the olive green with a bit of blue in it, just the odd, keep it quite simple this tree, don't want too much on this. Want it to be a bit more of a not quite there tree. Oops, a little bit more water just up here, touch more green. And then a bit of shadow, so some of our grey colours, just to get this a bit darker down at the base of the tree, get it to sit down into the ground a little bit. Perhaps we've got some of those darker root structures sticking out of the grass, coming back towards our exposed grasses. Bring that a little bit darker on the trunk. Okay, now just going to mop up some of these. Gonna need a bit more of our orangey browns. So the yellow burnt sienna, very orangey. Gonna put some of that into these grassy areas here. Break this up a bit. some of that in there. Just soften the edge off. Right, now I'm going to take some lighter greeny greys now, put in the lighter bits of branch and so on that are in the background. Some Payne's grey in that. I don't want this too strong, so plenty of water in it. So this is for cutting through some of these areas, just to make them a little bit more branched. So just with some very, very light greys. Just going to break up some of these areas to get the light to kind of pop through smaller holes rather than such big holes. Try not to get the shapes too similar. Just some little dashes and dots, which will just help to make those air holes a little bit smaller. Bits of blue. Just as a final few marks, I'm going to punch a few more little holes into my root bundle. So I'm just going to take some of the ochre gouache. So this is just the yellowy gouache, and make some more holes in the root structure. Trying not to make them too similar, but this will just break up this larger shape and make it feel like you're looking through it a bit more. Make it feel a bit more stringy and straggly. There, maybe the odd one down here. Don't want to go too mad with this. Bit in there, and then I'm going to have some spits and spots of this in my sand, and again try and keep that fairly random. Don't want them to be too replicated. Particularly in the distance up here, I want to keep them very small, because he does a big one. I take some yellow, actually a bit of white and a bit of red, make a pink up. Just the same, bit of gouache, bit of red, bit of white to make up a pink. A little bit of water with it. Fairly light, so So plenty of white in there. And this is just to give me some pinkier colours. In my pebbles, because it's quite a lot of red in the beach, or pink in the beach, I should say. A few bits of pink there. Probably have a little bit in here. Around my shadow. Coming down the beach line. Too dry for flicking. Have a little bit of the ochre again, just to pick out some of these grasses. Put some white with that to make it very whitey yellow, just to get some of this in, the odd grassy bit kind of in here. Spots there. There's a couple of lighter bits on the roots in there. Perhaps I'll pick out some of the holes in my netting. Could put some pinks in there, pinky yellows. For some colour, a bit more pink. Doesn't even have to make sense really, it can just, it's just a bit of colour within all these greens. A bit more red I feel, slightly more red. Have a few of those in here, these pinkier spots. And with that, I think we're done. I think we need just a bit more blue shadow. I'm going to take some of the ultramarine and the Payne's Grey to give me some bluer tones, so that I link this into my trees. I'm just going to lose some of these very light spots to give a bit more shadow, almost the reverse of doing the air holes. This is almost a dark hole, just a few darks here and there, just to try and link things, you know, this side to that side a bit more. Darker there, perhaps a bit darker here. Darker in the foliage there, couple of darks there.